You've seen a lot of coolers before, but you've never seen one quite like this. We're here at Cooler Masters booth looking at a unique CLC. You know, closed loop cooler. Standard radiator cooler. You mount the cooler on your CPU, it runs water through here, or a liquid, through a radiator, a fan blows through fins, cools it off, blows it in. One problem, if it's a warm room, like this room is right now, 75, 80 degrees, it's never gonna get cooler than that. You can't cool the water cooler than the room temperature.
So what's Cooler Master doing?
So what Cooler Master has done with their brand new CLC is they've integrated a thermoelectric cooler. That is a tech, it uses a Peltier effect. Electricity is run through it that helps cool it off, which then cools off the water in the radiator, which then connects to your CPU.
So how much cooler is it compared?
So for comparison, let's find out. I'm gonna find out. This cooler over here is about 80 degrees, which is what it feels like in this room in Computex. So let's check out what we're seeing in here. Darker color means cooler. And look, you're seeing we're getting 10 degrees cooler, and we're not even probably driving it that hard. But you can also see all of the heat here on the thermoelectric cooler. It does make a lot of heat as well as cooling it off, but hopefully only the cool stuff goes into the radiator. And again, and that's on the outside. If we go into the fins, we're looking at about 68, 69 degrees. So we're looking at maybe 10 degrees cooler.
So who wants this? Who's gonna use this?
So who wants this? If you actually live in a place where you need more cooling, like during the summer, if you work your house, summer, it's 90 degrees in your room, and there are some places that don't have air conditioning, it's gonna be a problem to keep your CPU cool. This can actually help it. You basically get a little extra cooling boost. And again, I know it's only 69 degrees, but I wish I could put this on my forehead because it feels a lot cooler. I mean, they're saying it's 20 degrees C at the water block. So, pretty cool. It's not perfect though. On the plus side, Cooler Master tells me it should put out about 300, it's rated for about 300 watt TDP. A standard 240 watt cooler is rated for about 180 watts if you're lucky, so that's 300, so you get that extra cooling headroom. The problem though, is it doesn't come free. You gotta run the thing, it needs electricity. So Cool Master tells me the unit tops out at about 150 watts on max, so you're using an additional 150 watts to cool the tech off, to cool your CPU off. So it's really a give or take. Is that really a plus or is that a minus? It's not there, and just so you know, there's no external power brick. It runs off of standard Molex or SATA power cables. Plug a couple of them in, it'll run the tech. But again, 300 watts of cooling, at least 10 to 15 degrees cooler. It's a fairly unique concept in today's age. Not the first one to do it, but it'd be interesting to see it tried again.